All right. There we go. Yes, we were doing a lot of the shits that Mid wants us to do for her. Which we did one of them. We collected that shit by the beach, I think. This is the second one. We need to go to Lawbert's Pass, which is Lost Wing. I think we're pretty caught up on side quests. We're pretty caught up on hunts. We're pretty caught up on everything that I could be doing. Leave anything you don't need behind. I want to get ahead. This one's distracting me. I wanted the brim out of my face. Alright, so where the frick is this? And of course, there's nothing close to it. Also, I think I said this last time, I don't like the look at this of this sword whatsoever. I hope we get a cool sword soon. As that would be, as the kids say, pretty pog. Yeah, I think this is the way to go. Wait. Yeah. Yeah, I think the way you improve this game doesn't need a lot. It needs a run button. It needs a run button bad. And, like, you need to be able to, like, run in towns. I think the thing that evens it out is having the chocobo. Which, like, I just frick people who didn't do the side quest, but, like, I'm down with that. Because I should get rewarded for doing the side quests. So I like that. But because you can't use the chocobo in towns, sometimes it gets a little annoying. Wow.
Time to fight.
Remember when I was level 15? Crazy. Oh, shit. I'm, like, almost out of healing items. All right, boys, what's going on here?
Thanks, girl.
Oh, there you are, Sid. Thanks so much for coming. The ruins are just over there, as is the creature I told you about, I'd imagine. Would you mind?
Of course. I'll be right back. Anybody home?
Oh, there's a chest down there. I've already fought one of these things for a hunt. This will be nothing.
This must be our unwanted.
This dude's doing too much. Are you kidding me?
Too slow.
Well, let's see if we can knock him out in one stagger bar. I don't think we're gonna be able to, but you never know. That actually did a frick ton. That's fine. Doesn't matter if he casts Doom on me.
The things I do for you, Mid.
Sid! Oh, thank goodness you're safe.
You shouldn't have any trouble now.
Indeed. Well, don't let us keep you. We'll, see that everything is transported safely back to the hideaway.
All right.
That one was pretty easy. Probably could have done that last time. I was getting so distracted looking at old clips and shit. Which is why I was like, eh, it's probably better to just end the stream. Or I think we ended up switching to Smash, but that will not happen today. Mark my words. Unless I feel like it. Weren't ready for that one, were you? Okay, where did I fight that dude? Because there was definitely a chest somewhere in that one cutscene where I found them, which I think was over this way. I talked to them. That was where I came in from. They were right here. And then I thought we moved this way. Maybe I just need to see it from the right angle. I could go. Oh, it's right there. I was gonna say, I could go back in the VOD and check. Oh, it's already open. God damn it. Gee Willikers, as some people say. Dang, Flabbit. That's gonna be my new one. I'm gonna coin that. Also, I'll finally be able to tell if my controller has a dead zone soon-ish, because I am planning on buying the Spider-Man 2 PS5 controller.
Here you are. Come again. I may have more for ya.
I was talked out of doing the collector's edition, which I still may. If it goes back on sale, and it's like not a rent paycheck when it does, I'm really considering it. I love the first game. Also, I still need to play the first game on stream. I played Miles Morales on stream because I got a PS5 day one and I streamed it. But I never played the original because I played the original before stream came out. So it might be time for a replay soon enough on stream. I can play like the PS5 remastered edition.
Helena has recovered the material for the helm. She'll be along shortly.
Excellent. Another job well done.
And just one remaining.
Right. Right, the shielding. This one's a bit of a bugger.
How so?
The plating's enough to stop the engines going pop, but those things will still be spitting out enough fire to set the rest of the ship ablaze. Which is why you need proper shielding. A prism for the dragon's breath that's blazing away inside. I thought a triple thick layer of tempered steel might do it. Or more of the stuff that the Fallen use, but they'd both be too heavy. The helm and the plating are bulky enough as it is. Add any more weight and the whole ship would be at the bottom of the briny before we'd even started. I need something light. But I've wrapped my brains and I just can't think what to do it.
Well, if I were in need of obscure knowledge, I know whose counsel I would seek.
Hippocrates. Yep, that's what I was, Tomes, that's his name, yeah.
Yeah, well, I'd thought
I was gonna guess that, Clive, you didn't give me the answer.
I've got all the details written down here. Can you take this to him?
I guess. Even though this should have been done before I did this. And she should have went to him weeks ago. And then I assume he's gonna give me whatever the next quest is, because I forget what they're called. Hang on. He's probably gonna give me Letting Off Steam 3, assuming that there's three parts, or we know that there's three parts, assuming that there's one quest per part, he'll probably give me the third one. Let me just double check. I know that there was a fourth thing here that I could have done, but it was in area ... Oh yeah, and it was S rank, so. It says it's in Rosaria. But hang on, I wonder if, because I can click nearby activities. Oh, so there is one here. But it doesn't tell you where, because you have to read it. Oh. What happens if I click ask about hunts? I wonder if he gives me more information. The Rosarian Ruins. No further than the village gate. Does he not? Does he have? He's telling me, I don't know about everything. The Rosarian Ruins. Which one is the? Would that be like here, or would that be like here? I'm gonna check up here for a second. Mainly just out of curiosity of how tough this thing is. I'm gonna save because I'm scared. I'm gonna save because I'm scared. We know that if it dismounts me off of off of Ambrosia, that we found it. Because the town, this path right here of the Dim leads to the town where that one lady was at, who was the wife of that one dude that I'm blanking on names, but she gave me like the my dad's clothes. So I'm wondering, because it was talking about village gates, it was talking about ruins, like, is this considered a ruin? Like, these aren't in ruins necessarily. Did I just decapitate him? No. I thought I saw something fly off of his body. That would've been freaking crazy. It would be crazy if it was here and I had to fight it like in her backyard or something. So it's not letting me back there. But it says I can go back there, but that might just been an earlier and it never edited the map or something.
It's over.
But I mean, looking through, oh, there's a level up. Looking through this entire place would definitely take way too much time. And I mean all this. So, and who knows, like it could be down here actually, and that would make a lot of sense because that might be why it says ?? So yeah, I think it actually probably makes the most sense to leave and just go back here. Go see our boy Tomes, whatever you want to call him.
Oh, I'm never drinking.
Harpocrates, do you have the moment?
For you, Clive? Always.
Well, actually, it's for Mid this time. Could you take a look at this?
For a mithril engine. Whatever will that girl think of next? And what are these notes around the edges?
She has some specific requirements for the materials. The shielding needs to be able to resist extreme heat on the inside, and yet remain cool enough on the outside not to set the ship alight, while also being light enough not to sink it. As you can imagine, she's struggling to find anything that meets her needs.
I see.
I wondered if you might know of a solution, or if you might be able to search the records for one.
Perhaps it is not a different material she requires, but a different approach.
That's what I said.
Consider the lake we have made our home. Its blighted waters eat away far more quickly than fresh water or even brine, at timber and steel alike. And yet, we have made a home here from those very materials nonetheless.
We have. But Bardolph must varnish every board twice over to keep it from rotting. And Obelus complains that without a constant supply of... pitch. I see.
Early Gregorian histories speak of a preparation known as Moondew. It is said to be able to resist even the most ferocious flames. Before the dragoons tamed the worms and wyverns of the realm, nobles would daub their castle walls with it in order to guard against dragonfire.
So if we could recreate it...
It might be applied to some material or other in order to provide the protection Mid requires. As to how best to apply it and to what material, perhaps Bardolph and Obelus might be of assistance. I shall speak to them and see what wisdom they might have to offer. If you would be so kind as to procure the necessary knowledge...
Yeah, I got you.
So you need a hand, do you?
We do. I'll be heading to market for the ingredients we need. I could do some help. And some company, too.
The other can assist me in researching how best to prepare the shielding itself.
Can we count on your aid?
Always. Well, if Jill's game.
Thank you.
I am sure either of these fine young minds would prove indispensable in my research. I leave the decision as to who...
Oh, I mean, I'm taking Jill. What the hell? Not that I hate Taria, but I mean, come on. Is this even a goddamn choice or what?
So, Clive, who will
Very well. So then, what do we need to find?
I have taken the liberty of preparing a list. Here.
White chocobo eggs.
Pepio nuts. Are you sure this list is right? Everything on here seems very edible. I would have thought the ingredients would be a little more exotic.
Though these items may seem mundane, they have potent effects that are rarely exploited, effects for which they were once highly prized. So much so, in fact, that they were harvested almost to extinction, hence Moondews having fallen from favor. Now, of course, they can be obtained with ease. You should be able to find everything you need at the market in Northreach.
Is that so? I've been meaning to visit Northreach anyway.
I will.
Is Northreach the place with that one brothel?
You two enjoy yourselves.
You too, Talia.
No. This is definitely Lost Wing, isn't it? No, this is Lost Wing. Clearly, this is Northreach. Everyone knows that. God damn it.
No.
Wait.
Jill.
Wait, no, this is it. Yeah. Yeah, because this is more. This is where the one quest with the dude and the. Had his wolf beat up someone. Yeah. I remember all this shit.
Do you see anything you like?
Oral sword. Oh, that's if I want to sell stuff. I'm rich as fuck.
Come back again.
Keep them pilchards nice and chilled. I'll have you spoiling another catch.
Are those Pepio nuts?
How goes the hunt for ingredients?
I've only just started. I'm sure everything we need is somewhere amongst all these stalls, though. Why don't we split up and see? We'll take a couple of ingredients each.
All right.
What are you looking for?
How about you look for Help Pepio me. Nuts and some garlic?
Why doesn't she want to be
we'll
with
find
me?
The other things we need. We can meet by the gate when we're finished.
This is El Riz, Clive.
You'll not find a bruised pippin in the bush. Fresh cuts. Come and get them.
Yo, do you actually have to buy it? Oh damn, you do. What if you don't have 10 gil? That's crazy.
I hope it's to your liking.
Hello, sir. I need a peepee nut. Thank you for the peepee nut, sir.
Let's see how Jill's getting on.
If Jill hasn't found it, we're gonna have some problems.
Did you find everything?
I did. Here.
Garlic and Pepio nuts. Perfect. Now all that remains is for Harpocrates to somehow turn all this into what Mid needs to keep her engine cool.
But is that all? Back, oh, okay.
Would you walk with me a while?
I was like, this quest can't be that short. I mean, like, it could, but. It can't. Yo, if this is not like a W Riz moment, that's crazy. But also the fact that you can miss this moment, if it is a W Riz moment, that would be crazy too. Why would I want Talia here?
Thank you for asking me to help you today. It makes a nice change.
It does.
Just say it, Clive. Look into our say, I love you. Say, I love you.
Reminds me of when we were children. Do you remember? Walking down Market Street in Rosalith, taking in the sights and smells.
How could I forget? What with Torgal's antics. Remember how his nose would prick up at the scent of sausages? He'd go racing away and we'd have to go running after him. We wouldn't catch you now, would we, boy?
Was there anything you wanted to buy for yourself while we're here?
There was, yes. Well, sort of. Molly in the kitchens told me about a place that sells particularly good pies. Thought you might like to share one with me.
I would love nothing more in life.
Thank you.
Literally nothing more in my entire being.
I saw some bread.
And, you know, I, picked up these condoms over here.
I'm sorry. Yo, what's up, bloke? What do you think? I thought we might get some soup to dip it in. But then I tried a slice of the butcher's dry cured ham and it was just, oh.
You're right.
Sorry. It's just... you're right. I really do feel like a child again being here with you. Clive.
I love you. Say it. Say, I love you.
I need to enjoy this.
No, Jill. This is how life should be. And it's how our lives will be when our work is finally done. When we can live on our own terms.
Yes, sir.
I hope so. Thank you, Clive.
Real? That's it? I wouldn't have even cared if it happened off screen. If, like, they were just inching towards each other, the camera panned up. I'd be fine with that. Just tell me that it happened.
Well, I suppose we better be getting back.
I mean, what the hell?
I need to get these ingredients to Harpocrates and Talia. I'll see you at the hideaway.
Take care.
And then we don't even go home together?
You too.
This is crazy to me. This is absolutely loco. Alright, so here's the thing. I got enough to summon twice in my mobile game. So I'm gonna do that real quick. Y'all ready for this? Oh, what the fuck? Waiting for my phone cam. Alright, motherfuckers. The unit we're hunting for is this. I have summoned an ungodly amount of times on this banner. Okay? Let it focus. This is who we want. Super Saiyan 3 Goku and Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. Okay? This is who we want. I have a third summon, and then every time you do three summons, you get a free summon. So I have three plus free right now. I can do two summons. And my luck has been stinky, caca poo poo, comma, stupid, comma, stinky. So far. All right. That means nothing. Usually, like, depending on who flies in with you, certain cool stuff will happen. This isn't going to be all garbaggio. I didn't even go Super Saiyan 3. This is going to be fucking... Oh, God. I mean, that's an SSR. That's cool, I guess. But I don't give a fuck about them. Listen to me. I don't give a single fuck about them, okay? I don't care. Oh, cool, an SSR. I don't give a fuck about you. Oh, my God. All right. Last one. Krillin. Okay, just Krillin is could mean that I... It means that you're going to get something on the banner. So this could be... This could be something good. Just Super Saiyan 1. Crack the screen. Okay, I didn't crack the screen. This could be bad now. Oh. It's an LR, which is the best kind of card you can get, but I've gotten this card so many times that a dupe is useless to me. This is an SSR trash. Oh. Oh, Lord. Okay, Blue. I'm just in my despair arc. When I tell you, so in Dokkan, which is that game, you can pull, so you have one unit as your base card, and then dupes are useful up until like five of them. After you get, or after four more. So one base plus the four dupes. After that, they become useless. I've probably pulled that LR 10 times now. It's just too much. I don't need him anymore. Like, the two LRs that are on that banner, I've pulled both of them. Probably one of them 7 times and one of them 10 times. Like, total since they've been out for years and years. But still, It's annoying as fuck. I just want the new unit. I got the other new unit. It's not like Jover yet. There's still time before the banners go away. But it might be Jover.
How's work on the shielding progressing, Harpocrates?
Well, very well indeed. And thanks in no small part to your kind assistance. I was just explaining to Taya how we might best go about preparing the Moondew. And now that we have all the ingredients, we may begin.
You can count on me. I've mixed more than a few mysterious concoctions in my time.
I'm sure you have. What about the shielding itself?
Work is underway, under the watchful eyes of Bardolph and Obelus.
Apparently, it'll be ready soon.
Thank you. All of you.
Right then. Jill, would you join me in the infirmary? Many hands make light work and all that.
Of course. Oh, and Clive, thank you. It was nice just being with you.
So why did nothing happen? Why did we leave separately? We could have gone home together. We could have held hands. How nice would that have been, Jill?
I was enjoying playing the man of action for once. When both the shielding and the Moondew are ready, it will merely be a matter of applying the one to the other. Followed by a rigorous process of testing and retesting, of course. Perhaps someone ought to warn young Mid of that.
Leave it to me. Thank you, Harpocrates.
Quest complete. I wonder if I can do anything with 5,000 experience points or ability points.
I'm gonna go and give Mid the good news then.
Started reading books that don't have any pictures in.
I don't care. Hello, ma'am.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Mid, but you'll be pleased to know that work on the shielding is underway.
You found something for it?
In a manner of speaking. Harpocrates knew of a substance that's highly resistant to heat. A coating that should provide the protection you need. He's supervising the construction and testing of the shielding as we speak.
Brilliant! I knew you wouldn't let me down.
Don't thank me.
Do we get to go to Cid's grave now?
Right then. Better start with.
He said that after we help her and the ship is built, that she'll visit her dad's grave with us. And that's all I want in life.
You know, when I got into the smithing game, I thought I'd be making swords and shields, not thermal bleeding didgeridoodars.
Didgeridoodars.
Displacement stacks.
Same difference. Whatever you call it, I ain't putting it together in here. It's cramped enough as it is. Let's take this outside. Mid, you get all the parts lined up on the deck. I'll take care of the rest.
On my way.
Oh, and bring me the biggest ammon you can find. This is going to require some precision, walloping.
Sometime later. Time skip. Also, apparently the first live-action One Piece trailer, like, because I think the one that they showed, like, a couple weeks ago was, like, a teaser or something. I think the first, like, trailer's coming out
it's
soon.
It's finally finished!
Yeah, the one was that was a month ago was teaser trailer. I've been feeling my hammer arm for weeks. Supposedly they're showing one today.
Thank you, Clive, Blackthorn, everyone. That's one down and just three more to go.
I'm sorry.
Oh, didn't I tell you?
Wait, is this it?
The Enterprise
it came out 3 minutes
four
ago.
Literal engines.
Is this? Oh my god, this is it. Hang on. I need to watch this on stream. Are you kidding me? React Andy. Here we go. If this isn't it, that'd be funny as fuck. But I think this is it. Hang on. Maybe if I click One Piece Day. Trailer official day One Piece. Trailer official do live action One Piece. I'm sorry. Bruh, One Piece live action trailer. I gotta say, that's a good Gold Roger. We're gonna watch it here in a second. But that looked like Gold Roger a little bit. Okay, let's watch it. Actually, can I just find it on YouTube? Videos. I need one. Yeah, this one, I think. Yeah.
Well.
Fame. Power.
Power. I found everything this world has to offer. Free yourselves. Take to the seas. My treasure is yours to find.
I'm into that Nami actress. Let me tell you what.
So what do you say? Are you with me? Mutiny.
Damn.
Why would anyone want to be a pirate?
This is the best thing there is.
Wind in your back. Salty sea air. Loyal crew by your side.
It's ready!
What is it?
We're Jolly Roger. We are.
The Straw Hat crew.
I love that they have the original Luffy drawn one.
A treacherous stretch of ocean with bigger islands, bigger pirates.
And that's where we're gonna find the One Piece.
Is that the frickin', so obviously it's what's-his-face behind him. But I think this is the servant maid boy. That, but like, he's the homie to Kaya.
And that's where we're gonna find the One Piece.
Also, that was definitely Mihawk. I don't know who that is. That's Mihawk.
And that's where we're gonna find the One Piece.
You've been making enemies everywhere we go.
Yo, the Chop Chop Fruit in action?
Chop Chop Cannon!
I mean, obviously, it's gonna be a little cringe when they call out their moves, but I mean...
Luffy, they are hunting you!
Guy, save your ass.
What? I saved your ass.
You'll have to excuse them. They're idiots.
That was funny. The Usopp will.
This crew, our crew, can handle anything.
Oh, okay, we're gonna see him here.
The kindness of killing you all together.
Okay, I mean, does he look cringe? Yeah. Was there a way to make him not look cringe? Probably not.
You're my captain from now until the end.
I'm gonna kick your ass, because no one messes with my friends.
Oh my god, it was Shanks!
My friends.
Shanks! Gatling?
What's so special about you?
Okay, I mean, the stretching animation honestly didn't look that bad. It could have looked much worse, probably.
I'm Monkey D. Luffy. And I'm gonna be King of the Pirates. I didn't know there were so many pirates.
It's terrible.
I know, right?
Bellamy?
Where's my face?
Right? Also, I just saw a post on Twitter. Cavendish is right here. Which, yeah, that's after Dressrosa. So, Blue, you know Cavendish. He's right here. Which, obviously, he wouldn't be there normally in the anime or manga. So, that's cool. I saw Foxy for a second. Alvida's obviously here. Yeah, there's Foxy. Bellamy. Looks fucking insane. Cool. The Arlong arc looks pretty cool, minus Arlong. I'll probably watch it, like I said.
And we'll be needing a displacement stack for each.
You don't mean...
Don't worry. Now they've got a finished one to work off. My gang in Canva can build the rest.
Good luck to them, I say. Right, I'm off to get a sling for this elbow. Any other work comes in, keep it to yourselves, eh? What's the matter?
Nothing. Just daydreaming. Thinking about the Enterprise sailing off over the horizon to shores unknown. Searching for a land untouched by the Blight. Just like me and my dad planned. So if the worst came to the worst and every scrap of soil in the Twins turned black, we might still have a chance. That's what she was meant to be. You see, one last chance just in case we needed it. But now she's so close to being finished, I've realized... I don't want her to be that. I don't want her to be just a lifeboat for us to cling to if things get desperate. I want people to sail aboard her by choice, not from the lack of it. In a world where we're not just trying to survive, but where we can actually live.
I'm working on that. And I'll do everything I can to get you what you want.
Don't you always? All right. My mind's made up. As soon as the Enterprise is fit to sail, I'm putting her under your command.
Hell yeah.
Sod our plans. I'm trusting in yours.
Are you sure about this?
Something tells me it's what my dad would have wanted.
He'd be proud of
you. I'm gonna be a freaking pirate now.
You were gonna visit his grave, weren't you?
No, we were gonna visit his grave.
And you can come too now that your little project is finished.
Right. There's just one thing I need to finish up first. Won't be a mo.
All right. I'll let Otto know you're coming. Meet us in the mess when you're ready.
Aye, aye, Captain.
A new quest is available. And there's a plus quest here. Alright, let's take care of those.
She was building a ship.
Okay, no new board here.
How are you doing? Here you go.
All right, so it's just these two quests here then.
Just the man to help me out of a bit of bother.
Let's hear it.
Well, it's about this alembic the chief's got me making. Lovely bit of kit, it is. bunging a solution you want split in, and it will separate it out, just like that. Problem is, it won't always get rid of all the impurities. And with some of the stuff we need it for, that ain't good enough. Which is why I've been looking for something to filter the liquid we'll be cooking off. And that's where I was hoping you could help me out.
I imagine Ty could get some use out of this alembic too. Distilling medicines and the like. All right. Why not?
Proper job!
So what exactly do you need for this filter?
Nothing but bomb ash will do, says the chief. Gave me a sample she'd obtained from the university stores. Couldn't believe my eyes. You pour the blackest blight water through it, and it comes out clear as a mountain stream. So, I did a bit of reading about where I might be able to get hold of some. And do you know what I found out? It's only the blimmin' bones of a...
Oh, I hate the bomb enemies.
I would have gone myself, but...
All right.
Wait.
Thank you.
Didn't he just say... It was on the hunt board? Did I do it? Oh, you use this to get a hunt board, I guess. Like, if you don't do this quest, maybe it never shows up there or something. Which is kind of cringe. Ask about bomb sightings. Here we go. Okay, this one's in the Croc in Sandbreck. Can probably do that whenever. Like, it's a B rank, I mean, so... In terms of levels, it should be fine. I'm gonna go claim the quest that's at our desk. And I'll just go do both at once while we're out.
Crack the crystal too.
Oh my god, three quests! Holy frick! Okay, off the record, I was thumbing through the hideaway ledgers at Otto's behest and might. How's your car doing? Hasn't given me too much problems since the thing happened that one time. But, I mean, sometimes, like, if I go, like, kind of fast, like, around, like, 60, which I haven't hit 60, and 60 is what I was hitting the day it happened, I think. Sometimes it feels, like, a little weird. But as long as I'm going, like, normal speeds, it runs fine. I also think part of, like, when it feels weird might just be, like, PTSD. Not actually PTSD, obviously, but just, like, I'm being triggered that I feel like something's wrong even though nothing's wrong. But, yeah. How's your car doing ever since you got it back after 7 years?
Trouble with the ledges. Shouldn't he be asking Otto for help?
Why, if something ain't right with that hound of yours, when it pleases your lordship, come pay me a visit at the toll.
What could be wrong with Torgor?
The pen is mightier. Open 10 letters of the rating table. Cheers for your help dragging Blackthorn out of the dumps the other day. Thing is, I reckon he's gone and thrown himself back in, judging by the droop of his jowls lately, so I'm thinking maybe it weren't just the leather what was on his mind. Maybe there's other demons jabbing their pitchforks into his privates. I know you're a busy bloke, but next time you find yourself free, maybe we go and ask the old bastard what's got him so hot and bothered, assuming it ain't just the forge.
Hopefully it's nothing. But I should speak to Blackthorn just in case.
Blacksmith Blues 2. Alright, let's go do all that shit then.
Blackthorn, do you have a moment?
Not really, no.
This won't take long. I just wanted to ask how you're getting on. August was worried about you, and you might still be doubting your craft. even after learning the trick of that cuirass.
That cure what?
Something else weighing on your mind. Perhaps sharing your thoughts might help.
That bastard's like a dog with a bone. Still, he's got a keen eye, I'll give him that. He's just, well, Karen showed me something. Something I've never seen before.
And that was?
A sword. An odd-looking thing with a single-edged blade. The metal itself wasn't anything to write home about, but fuck me. The edge on it. You could slice a man clean in two with a weapon like that, and he'd be halfway home before he even realized he'd been cut.
So that's what's troubling you?
Not troubling me exactly. More distracting. Can't stop thinking, how do you get an edge that sharp? It's driving me mad.
And if you knew how to do it, we could arm the curse breakers with even better blades.
That's about the size of it, yeah.
I'll see what I can find out. Sharper swords are always welcome, and we can't have our master blacksmith being distracted.
You're a soft touch, you know that. But I can't say I'm not grateful for it.
Thank you. Let's see what count.
All right. We gotta go for two quests, then.
I got your note. You think something's wrong with Torgal?
So you can read. Congratulations.
I don't need the sass, ma'am.
But I didn't say I were wrong with him. I said something weren't right. He's not been eating me treats. He used to love cracking the bones from Molly's boiled brown, but now he won't so much as look at him. I didn't like him.
Like, I guess so, but I also haven't tried as a thing.
His mind's on something else.
Like, I could try it, see what happens. I'm just scared to try it.
Harder than usual. Is that it, boy? You need a rest.
What was it you said he was? A frost wolf?
That's what the Lawsman seems to think.
Then maybe this all has something to do with whatever it is that's woken inside him.
I suppose things happen different since Rosaleth. Perhaps Harpocrates knows something.
Instead of everything, you mean? Perhaps.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if I have to go on it, obviously I will, but... I usually don't have to. Like, even if I need to go somewhere, I'll take the long road.
I want to know about the sword you showed Blackthorn. Single-edged and extremely sharp.
Running around after him again, are you?
I suppose I am, yes. But I need to help him find out how to work an edge like that. It's driving him to distraction.
Little wonder, I suppose. There's not many like that make it as far as the twins, and those that do go straight into private collections. Which made it nice and easy finding a buyer.
Can you tell me who bought it? Where is it now?
You think I tell people who my clients are? Suppose you're not likely to go nicking him off me, are you now? Fine. If you stop mooning at me like that. Lord Ignac's the man you want. Del Mechian. And he's got more money than... Reckon he'll still be at the...
Thank you, Cat.
Oh. And he's...
I appreciate...
All right. We will do that in a second. I'm going to speak to Goat and I'm going to speak to Holmes. And then we'll leave and do all four quests.
Lawsman, I need to ask you about Torgal. Something's not right with him.
He isn't ill, is he?
I don't think so. But according to Lady Karen, he seems to have lost his appetite. Which is certainly a new development. She says he's hardly been touching his bones of late, and she believes it may have something to do with what happened at Rosaleth Castle.
I rather think she might be right, though not about his appetite. All canids are instinctively inclined to crack open
never got hit. Nice.
Each marrow that resides within, and I see no reason why a frost wolf should be any different. Accordingly, I suspect it is not a lack of appetite that afflicts Torgal, but a surfeit of it. If we assume... that his newfound magics require additional nourishment to sustain. It may well be that the bones Lady Karen is accustomed to providing are no longer sufficient. Frostwolves, after all, habitually prey upon far larger animals. As to where one might find a suitable substitute,
I don't recall.
And little wonder. The last,
even so,
good hunt.
All right, let's do that. Bunch of quests. Oh, in Cressida, which is that one town that we freed for that one dude.
Ugh, I'm never...
told me she was building a ship.
Seeing Oppenheimer tomorrow too. Well, that should be fun. Probably no stream because of it, but I mean, it's also the weekend, so I could stream a little later. But the movie's not till 6:30.
Otto won't be listening.
And,
is this better?
So it would end at like 9:30.
Listen. I've some bad news. It turns out the
we're in debt.
May be slightly behind in its payment to certain lenders, and it's maybe my fault. But I swear to
Goat's fired.
That square turned out to be more of a circle. Zero, you might say. I can straighten it out. I swear. I'm going to need help.
Be late.
There you are.
So let me get this straight. You forget to pay our lenders what they're due, and instead of coming straight to me, you get Clive to come to you. And I will dig you out of the hole. You've the man in charge of the place you've been cheerfully trying to bankrupt. And you thought this was a cunning plan. Why? Well, who needs paying?
Oh, just Martha. And the day.
We do I have to, like, $5 million?
Trusted friend. Each. They lent us the bulk of the money we used to rebuild the hideaways.
Listen, Charon, we can say frick it, we house her.
Judges were my responsibility.
Frick paying her back.
And it was my decision to entrust them to you.
Do we have that much to hand?
No, we don't. And no, you won't. After the king's ransom we had off him, he deserves better than to see our besides. We'll need to learn to stand on our own.
All right. Is there anything...
There might be. How'd you fancy taking the...
Rocks.
Rocks, he says. Worth 1,000 talents apiece. Little something Sid and I set aside. And I reckon 15 million in overdue debt probably qualifies.
I'm sure that...
But you know how it is with this place.
I know.
Go. Do you know why I only gave Master Clive here 2 star rubies?
Because you'd rather Lady Charon killed me.
Because I'd rather Lady Charon killed you. Yes.
Well,
don't worry.
Really?
No.
Damn. Okay. Now we can go out and do shit. That one monster was in Sandbreck. In not the Vale. This is where we're. It was Sandbreck. Once I see the name, I'll remember it. Hang on. Okay, well, I'm also seeing this that I never been to, so it could be down here. It also could be down here, I suppose. It was the something, and I feel like that something started with a C or an S. And I don't remember what now. Aren't I right there, actually? Okay, I can just talk to him again. The croc. The croc in Sandbreck. Yeah, and it says that there's a mark, obviously, here. That's the Norvent. I guess let's just try down here, see if there's something there. There's one other place it could be potentially. But that would also make it to where I can't get it right now because it's currently blocked off my map said. So I'm sort of just hoping it's here. Frick. Because yeah, there's this over here. And that's the only other place that I can see that's not named. There's also this, I guess, but there's no way. I guess I could just look up where the croc is. Oh, I'm dumb. It was this way. I just took the wrong exit. I'm counting that as a dub then, because I technically knew where to go. I just didn't turn here. This was still the part of the map I never looked at. Yeah, this way. And the Imperial Chase, here we go. And then the croc is right there. The croc pod, if you will. My battery's low. No. How about them apples? No.
No need to ride from here.
Blue, beat me in Smash and then call my low battery cringe. Boom. I'm just gonna hold that over everybody that I beat that day. AKA everyone except Josh. Even if you beat me in the future, I beat you at my weakest. I've been training, doesn't matter. I beat you at my weakest. You'll always have that over your head. This looks like my balls, I'm sorry. You know what, I'm not. It does. Mine are on fire too.
Look what we have here. Greetings, Your Majesty.
You in the tournament? What were you guys doing yesterday? I thought you guys were training, but I was watching something. You really have been training.
Yeah.
the fuck is white? It's whiten. What does that mean? I don't like this. I'm scared. What the fuck is going on? Texting me. Blue, if you don't think that Mario Party is practicable, you probably already lost, man. So get that through your fucking mental. Oh!
Catch you already.
Yeah, fuck you. Yeah, fuck you. God damn. With the voice crack and everything! Bomb Ether. Bomb Ember. I can't read. It doesn't say Ether anywhere on my screen. Like, it's not even like I looked somewhere and I thought I read Ether and I just switched the two words. I'm just dumb.
Your reign is over. Now to collect the air. This looks like the stuff. Let's see if there's any more.
Trailer Park Boys? No, that show, the picture always weirded me out. Like the one dude in the glasses.
That should do it.
That dude freaked me out. Did I watch it? I think today I'm gonna try and finish Demon Slayer Season 3. That's on my docket for tonight, depending on when I end stream. Because I got two normal sized episodes, and then I think their last episode is like an hour special. I'm gonna try and finish that today. And then I don't know what I'm gonna watch after that.
I come bearing gifts.
Gifts? Whatever is the occasion.
Because we owe you money, bitch. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have said that. We owe you money, woman.
Oh my. Clive, you really have outdone yourself.
Otto asked me to give it to you. To settle the hideaway's debt with the Veil. And to compensate you for the time it took us to do so.
Oh, you disappoint me, Clive. I thought you might finally be warming to me. Tell Otto he can keep his baubles. I tried to tell him as much the first time around. The man owes me nothing, nor does the hideaway.
How nice.
My contribution to the restoration effort was made freely and willingly. It was the least I could do.
You once told me Sid did you a kindness. I'd like to do the same.
Aw, how nice.
For my sake.
Listen, if you want to repay me, you can let me have unlimited...
It is...
Women at this brothel.
Isn't it? Very
well. And then we'll be square.
Otto is lucky to have you, Clive.
I know.
Doubt anything could ever replace his son. But you and the others at the hideaway are the closest thing he has to family.
Otto had a son.
Long ago. Yes. Sid told me Otto lost him when he was just a boy and blamed himself for not being able to stop it. I don't know how it happened, whether there was anything he could have done, but it was clear that it weighed heavily on him.
I didn't know.
How could you have? I doubt anyone did. Besides Sid, I've never met a man more keen to bear his sorrows in stoic silence. An ill habit, given that both have always been surrounded by friends desperate to help.
Thank God I accepted all these side quests at once. I would have been so mad if I had to go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Golly. Alright, let's go. Wait, where's Cressida? That's here? Local map? Yeah, that's Cressida. Alright, so we'll do this stuff then. It's on Netflix, right? Maybe I'll check it out. You know what episode I already, what show I watched like an episode of and I just couldn't get into it? I was also watching with like a friend of mine, so maybe I just like wasn't paying attention. Letterkenny.
Clive, we weren't expecting
I think it's
you.
On Hulu. I could not get into that show.
To be here, but it seems we still owe you a considerable amount of coin for your help with our rebuilding efforts. And though I doubt it's what you were expecting, we were hoping you'd take this. As payment.
A star, Ruby? I can't accept this. It's worth at least twice what you owe me. More if you can find yourself the right buyer.
Think of the difference as interest.
Interest? If word got out I charged that much, no one would ever borrow from me again. Anyway, why are you the one here asking me about this? I'd have expected Otto, bit much sending the Lord Marquis out to sell your debts, isn't it? The old goat working himself to death again?
Something like that. Most days I think he's the only reason the hideaway's still standing.
Same as always, eh? Back when the place was nothing but a twinkle in the eye of a recently retired Lord Commander, word is he was the first one Sid reached out to. Probably knew that without his strong arm and level head, the idea would never get off the ground. Sid may have been the face of the hideaway, but Otto's always been the backbone. And when Sid passed away, we were all worried that would be the end of it. That Otto would just give up.
His death was hard on everyone. But it must have hit Otto hardest of...
But he didn't give up, did he? Quite the opposite, in fact. If I recall, he was the one who nominated you as Sid's replacement. And rallied the rest around you. I reckon what he saw in Sid, he saw in you. And don't we all... Doesn't hurt that you're half as stubborn and twice as handsome, neither.
Yes, ma'am.
That,
you can say that again.
You keep good company.
Well, I guess I'll see you later. Why does no one say
good
bye in video games?
Delivered, if he's still with us.
Like, no one ever says, well, see you later. That conversation literally just ended with, and you keep good company. What does that mean?
Faster.
I also need to watch, I might wait till it's over. I'm undecided. But I need to watch Jujutsu Kaisen Season 2. Because that started, I think it's like on Episode 3. Season 1's obviously fire as shit. And I've read parts of Season 2. So I'm excited for that. I also need to... There was something else I need to watch. But I can't remember now. Damn, these things are level 33.
We'll find one bigger than that. You hungry, Torgal?
That is crazy, the amount of damage that does.
I say that answers my question, which means we owe the Lawsmen our thanks. You're just a big puppy, aren't you? A very big puppy. You do know you can take that with you, Torgal. Lady Karen will be relieved to hear you've got your app.
Do I have to talk to her again, or is the quest done? Son of a bitch. Okay, all I need to do now, before I go back to the hideaway, is do the Dalamil one. Which this is the one that will, or no, there's two that will unlock something. There's this one, and then the Bomb King one also was an unlock.
People take notice of wealthy men. Shouldn't be too hard to track down Karen's collector.
The Zendrate's fang is gone. The whole Mother Crystal gone.
Hello? Is anyone here?
My reputation will be ruined! Ruined!
Calm yourself, Lord Ignac, I beg of you, before you do yourself a mischief.
Pardon the intrusion, but...
Out! Get out! I paid for these rooms so I wouldn't be disturbed. Leave me be!
Please, allow me to apologize. His lordship is going through a difficult time. And he's never been fond of guests arriving unannounced.
Radim! Get rid of the filthy oaf this instant!
Very good, Lord Ignac. Would you mind stepping outside for a moment?
I'm sorry if I've caused you any trouble.
That? No, no, no. That's just how his lordship is. Though the morning's events have left him somewhat fractious. He has been dispossessed of his luggage, you see. The thieves also made away with a considerable amount of coin. Coin the innkeeper will soon be keen to collect.
I don't suppose a certain blade was among the stolen items. A single-edged sword. It was purchased from a merchant friend of mine.
Ah, You know Lady Karen.
Then I'll retrieve Lord Ignac.
You have but to state it.
I want an audience with Lord Ignac.
A condition I would...
I don't suppose you saw...
I did not. No. Every...
Oh, I know where that is.
I shall...
That will be very...
Farewell.
I don't think there's a single teleport there, but I know where that is. Cool. I guess the closest one is here, and then just... run on over.
Come on.
All right, let's kick all their asses, as I normally do. Why is that enemy's name Bedmaker? I'm just so good at this game. Also, I learned that apparently in this game, I don't know if I mentioned this, I might have. You can't get the Ultima weapon, which is just like in most this Final Fantasy games, that's luggage. Like the best weapon you can get.
Nothing seems to be damaged.
You can't right. get it in the actual game. You can only get it on Final Fantasy mode, which is basically this game's new game plus. That kind of sucks. I might do that like on my own time. Definitely wouldn't do it on stream, but...
I hear I have you to thank for the return of my effects. What shall I call you, my good man?
Wyvern. Glad to make your acquaintance.
Oh, that was my first name in the game.
A formidable name indeed. Well, Wyvern, I appear to be in your debt. Redeem here tells me you wished for an audience. Is that all?
A few moments of your time should suffice, yes.
You're a peculiar fellow, Wyvern. All right. Speak.
Master Wyvern was wondering if you could tell him about a certain single-edged sword you recently acquired.
Oh, a true work of art, that one. Karen drove me hard on the price, but I would have sold her Radim here to get my hands on that sword. It was made in the Outer Isles, far beyond the Twin, and is used exclusively by the practitioners of a unique school of swordsmanship. They believe no combat should ever exceed a single strike and hone their blades to such perfection that none ever does. Each sword is made for that one perfect stroke, and for that stroke only. They crack upon a second blow.
There's Damn.
A brutal sort of beauty to it, really.
But how do they hone such an edge?
Fine question. Why, they use a whetstone, of course. Whetstones, rather. A whole array of them, ranging from the coarse to the fine. 10,000 licks with the sharpening stone, then 10,000 more. But it is the final stone which lends the blade its legendary sharpness. A mineral quite foreign to this great realm of ours. And that is the key. The secret ingredient. Wyvern, it occurs to me that my little lecture is hardly equal to services rendered. Take this, together with my regards. The very stone of which I spoke, far rarer among collectors than even the blade itself, and a far more fitting payment.
All right, you're a bitch, but like, thanks, man.
Intrusion, my...
I am locked in. I am one step ahead.
Are there many...
Too many to count.
He just looks so mad.
One do I consider my nemesis.
My uncle.
Lord Byron Rosfield. And is a perennial thorn in my side.
I can imagine.
Farewell, Wyvern. Ready?
If there's a third quest in this line, I hope it includes my uncle meeting him again.
Thank you again. Coming, my lordship.
Like if we have a Blacksmith's Blues 3 or whatever.
Trust Uncle Byron to find such an interesting rival. Now, let's see what Blackthorn makes of this whetstone, shall we?
Okay, let me check. All of my quests currently should be returned to the hideaway. Deliver the bomb ash in the hideaway. Deliver to Blackstone. Blackstone. Blackthorn. That's his name. Return to the hideaway. Return to the hideaway. Okay, cool, cool, cool. Okay, the main story is that way, so let's just go. We'll go around like this. We'll bring it around town.
I noticed you and Torgal had gone off somewhere. So. Molly's leftovers weren't good enough, eh? That'll teach me for treating you like you're still a pup. All right, no need to shout. Now we know what you're after, I can see about getting some in.
Speaking of which, I brought one for later. Can I leave it with you?
Hang on, a lot of news is coming out right now. About, like, games and movies coming out. Like, Invincible Season 3 shit. I mean, Season 2 shit. All right, here you go, ma'am.
You can, eh? I'm nice like that. In return, you can thank Tomes for me. The bloody know-it-all.
I was just on my way to see him.
This is ruining my entire bring it around town strategy that I was gonna do.
Ah, Clive. Were you able to locate your quarry?
We were indeed, Lawsman. You pointed us in exactly the right direction.
Very good, very good.
Lady Karen sends her thanks, by the way, for your part in solving the mystery.
Ah. But that reminds me. After your last visit, I found myself pondering Torgal's talents. Do you recall our conversation concerning Lady Jill's role in Torgal's transformation?
About how she somehow woke the power within him.
Precisely that. A reasonable conclusion, I thought. But one which raised certain questions in my mind. You see, the Fenrir of legend served Shiva and Shiva alone. And while the powers attributed to him are certainly impressive, the records imply they are somewhat different in nature.
Oh, okay, so he's not took
to
Fenrir.
You described Torgal as having used.
What are you suggesting?
That Torgal may be the beneficiary of more than one icon's power. Consider that in addition to Lady Jill, he has served as a loyal companion to you, your brother, and even the late Cid. In short, the icons hitherto near at hand, or should I say at paw, have been diverse and plenty, and that number has only grown as the realm's dominance have fallen to your sword. One can but speculate as to how all of this has affected Torgal.
He has seemed more fierce of late.
And if I am not mistaken, he will grow fiercer still. We are fortunate indeed to be able to count him amongst...
That's crazy. That, like, all this Torgal lore is just an aside quest. I think I really say that with most side quests in this game, but still. Also, was that an accessory I just got? Yeah. Slightly increases Torgal's attack potency. Eh. I don't care that much.
Sorry for the wait, but hopefully you'll agree it was worth it.
You learned something about that sword then?
I did better than that.
I cared? Well, maybe you should be playing this game then.
Why? A whetstone? Yes. But not one you'll find anywhere in Valisthea.
No wonder I couldn't get a sane finish on the grinding wheel. One hit and all done, eh? Might not be so bad if all you ever fought were duels. Good luck on the battlefield. Your second opponent would be your last, no matter how good you were.
Even so, is there some way it could be used to give the curse breakers an edge?
I think so, yeah. With this whetstone and the right kind of steel, I could probably even make a twin of the blade to rattle me. But there'd be no replacing this little rock once I've worn it down to a sliver. I reckon we get a dozen swords from it, if that. Swords that the curse breakers wouldn't know how to wield properly, and that would see them through a single fire piece. Nah, no point trying to copy that thing. Be about as much use as a wax anvil. But finishing our blades with a whetstone is fine. Now that's something to consider. And what's finer than fallen masonry, eh? Or just imagine it. Good Valisthean steel with an edge as sharp as any found in the Outer Isles. I won't make a copy now.
I'm sure they could just...
I've been working day and night since I was off. Hey, thanks, Clive. I mean it. I owe you one. August 2. It's good to know.
You'll be happy.
And I'll see that my debt to you's paid. So you come and find me.
Right.
All right, do I have the materials? Because that would be pretty pog. Excalibur. Cool. Can I make it?
Back, are you? What do you want?
Oh my god, I can! Oh, it's so much better!
Not bad, if I do say so myself.
Oh, and now I don't need to care about the diamond sword because it's worse.
Anything else?
Hell yeah. Does this look cool? That's what I care about the most. I mean, it's fine. It's nothing like some of the cooler, like, icon blades that we've gotten.
Sid, how's that hunt for the bomb ash going?
I have it here.
All right, I imagine this is gonna unlock something on like Clive's wall or whatever that's called. And
plenty of it too.
Or I don't know what else it would be.
You're a right then. Telamon the Limbic, and it works just like the chief said it would.
Very impressive.
Says the man who cut down a burning boulder. Speaking of which, I still haven't returned a favor.
There's no need. The good it will do for the hideaway is rewarded.
Don't be... Why don't you let me take a look at that bag of yours? The one you keep your potions in. Reckon I could work some magic on that, huh?
What?
Hey, yo.
Well, we happen to have isolated a substance in our test run of the Alembic. Thought we might use it to breathe new life into old boots and the like.
Wait.
I reckon if we slap.
Oh, frick yeah. I'll only be a mo.
What do you reckon?
It certainly feels more flexible.
Right? Told you.
Thank you. I think.
No, no. Thank you for supporting Mid and the rest of us in our endeavor. And I'm telling you.
There's more where that came from? Fuck yeah. Treated potion satchel. That's awesome. I had no idea that would even be a thing in this game. I can now carry six potions and four high potions. And I don't care about the tonics. I never use them.
She threw it right back in my face, in fact, and told me I could stick my stupid stone where the sun don't shine.
Karen refused payment.
I hope it wasn't something I said.
I'm sure you were as tactful as ever.
Why do I need to go? If she didn't want the payment, she didn't want the payment. Done deal. This quest will be over.
Mid told me she was building a ship.
Do you prefer the
Montag? I don't. I may have tossed a talent or two, but those were donations.
Of course not. But surely you wouldn't shun the ground.
Oh, fine. but I'm selling it and taking what I'm owed, then... Where'd you even get this? A decent trader might... A canny one, meanwhile, might claim it were nicked from the belt of Sid the Owl. Might be I or might be you even know her. A fine continental maid whose beauty one man would...
Not at all.
Finally.
I hear you ended up delivering all three stones. Thanks to this lump. I sometimes wonder what I pay you for.
Speaking of which, I still haven't been paid last month's wages.
Oh, so you remember what's owed to you then? Get your ass behind that disc of yours and don't get up before those ledges are square.
Right away.
I've seen that before.
Yeah. Plenty of times. It was the only goblet Sid ever used. Either out of habit, or because the filthy soul couldn't be bothered to find a clue.
Oh, this is gonna go on our back wall.
Little about it. Martha and the Dame both seem to have fond memories of him.
I bet they do.
How long did you know Sid before he...
Before he died. 20 summers.
Damn.
Give or take. Back in the day, I was a purser on a trade ship, which is where I met him. He bought passage to... I forget where. And having nothing better to do on the long nights, we set up drinking island rum till the morning bell dragged me back to my duties. Quit my post not long after that. On account of making a fine maiden's belly fat. But me and Sid stayed close, promising we'd one day sail the seas again. That was before fate stepped in and said she was having none of it. The magic woke inside my son soon after his first name day, and there was no hiding his knack.
Couldn't you and your family have?
My family were the ones who summoned the constable, wanted the monster taken away. I couldn't turn my back on him, forget what I felt, and I couldn't for the life of me understand how they could. Luckily, Sid was of the same mind as me. It was him who stood beside me when all I wanted was to tear the whole world down. Him who cried for me when I had no tears left of my own.
Sid was the homie, man.
Who swore he'd do everything he could to stop it from happening again. And he was true to his word, too. Left the Royal Army once and for all. His ranks, his ribbons, gone. Just like that. Threw away everything he had. All to right a wrong that no one else had the courage to face. I knew then I'd follow that man to the ends of the earth.
Shouts out that guy. Oh my god, I get to hear his voice again.
Too clever for his own good, was Sid. Saw the world for what it really was, while the rest of us were content to go along with the lie we were shown. And it can't have been easy, bearing that burden alone.
Unless I don't get to hear his voice again.
But he didn't let it stop him. He never lost faith in what he believed was right. And that gave us faith in him. Faith he'd steer us true. So I swore to myself that I'd always be right behind him, ready to catch the stubborn sod if ever he should fall.
Damn, I didn't even get to hear him again.
But I couldn't even do that. Ignore me. Just the ramblings of a tired old man.
Leave that lot. I'll tidy it up in a bit.
This is Sid's handwriting. Dear Otto.
I may be drunk.
We do get to hear his voice again.
This place would be fucked without you. Love you, you grumpy old sod.
Damn, you gotta play the side quest in this game.
This note.
What about it?
Sid was right. Without you, we'd all be lost.
He should have bloody well said so then. Just once.
Let it out, man.
Before he went.
Let it out. It's okay.
But then, why would he? Him or anyone? I'd only have told him to piss off. You're wrong, though. Both of you. It was never just me keeping the hideaway afloat. It was all of us. I just shoved people in the right direction. I barely seem to be able to do that anymore.
Would you rather go at the helm?
Well, maybe I've got a few more years left in me.
I'm going to hold you to that, Otto.
Before you go, Sid would have wanted you to have this.
But that's...
This will do me just fine. Thanks for the ray of sunshine. I'll see if I can't pay you back.
Already have.
Boom. Sid's goblet. Hell yeah. Shouts out. Oh, we have a new reward. I'm not gonna go check out the wall just yet. I'll go next time I'm over there.
Oh, I wasn't expecting you back so soon.
I'm sure the story will take me there eventually.
Here you are.
Cool. High cleric's medallion.
There's a block out there, Sid.
And then we'll go visit the grave. Increase healing potency of high potions by 25%. That's cool. Don't want it though.
All right, Clive. Astrix, we'd finished sending half the hideaway traipsing across the twins, has she? I swear, that girl'd do anything to put off visiting her old dad's grave. No excuses now, though, eh?
Not quite. She said there was one final thing she had to take care of. I'm sure she'll be finished soon enough.
She said that?
She...
Clive, were you born yesterday or something? There is no thing.
She'll probably be halfway to Canada by now.
Damn, she fucking debated me. I honestly kind of hope that, like... We don't even get her to Sid's grave until the end of the game, and it's just a bunch of closure. Like in the last cutscene, we go visit his grave or something. That'd be kind of cool.
Yep. In a boat, going that way. You in a hurry at all, are ya? Oh, I offered to take her across, but she wouldn't wait. Just paid for a dinghy and rowed off. Oars going like the clappers. Got some life in her, and she. But anyway, I was on my way up to see you, as it happens. Got a letter for you. Urgent, by the sound of it. One of your uncle's men said I was to hand it to you in person, post.
Thank you.
Don't me.
What tidings of...
My dear boy, my journey to Canver has been a resounding success. That friend I mentioned had not only agreed to share the contents of his strongbox with us, but his considerable knowledge of the goings-on in free cities, by which I've learned of the endeavors of a certain young friend of yours. Though I, for one, believe Miss Salomon's project to be quite the valiant enterprise, I doubt the Canvarian authorities will take kindly to the unauthorized use of their dockyards, no matter how deserted, and if rumor has already reached my friend, it may not be long before the guildmasters are rapping at my door, or at our door. Which is why I pen you this note. I would like to borrow your man Gav for a moon or two, that he might keep a watch on those who might mean our little fellowship ill, and warn us of any impending attack. I trust you will give this proposal your full consideration, your loving uncle, Byron.
Trouble in Canver. Well, I'll need someone to keep an eye on Mid.
Why can't I just go?
So what? Mid got us to do all the dirty work and then just sailed off into the sunset?
It seems that way.
Well, nothing we can do about it now. But next time you plan on visiting Cid, you might want to tie her to something before you suggest it.
Ah, don't be so hard on her. Gotta admit, the dirty work was kind of fun. Everyone pitching in, all that bollocks. Just like when we built this place.
You're right.
Anyway, we all set to head to the old hideaway. I could do with getting to Canver pretty sharpish. Wouldn't do to keep Lord Rosfield of the Seven High Houses waiting now, would it? Not after he asked for me personally.
Gav will be leaving with me. Will you mind the place while we're gone?
You can count on me. Just be sure we'll give Sid and the others my regards.
Oh, by the way, Jill will be joining us too. She's got some things to take care of.
I hope she...
Whoa. The old hideaway. Also, was this always like this? Or is this new? These chains in the ground. Oh, I don't know. Oh yeah, I think that's just like the territories. Like all this is Rosaria. This is all Dalmechia. Yeah, never mind. Cid's Legacy. That's a good name for it.
Sid, I remember what you told me. But if no one is listening to what you have to say, you may as well not say it. But I will say this, old friend. Hugo Cooker is gone. His shadow looms over us no longer.
It's a pity the Phoenix can't be in two places at once. If he'd have been with us, maybe he could have done something for the lost.
Not even the Phoenix can bring people back from the dead. Life has a beginning and an end. So we must live while we have the chance.
I wonder if this game is gonna like
slaves to the crystals.
Create like this universe's like world's first Phoenix down or something, and like Clive gets like stabbed, and then the Phoenix feather that Joshua gave him acts as a Phoenix down, bing bang boom, and then he comes back or something.
Lady Karen, what a pleasant surprise.
I thought I'd drop by and see how you were all doing before heading off to restock my supplies. wasn't the most scenic view back then, but it were never as bad as this.
I know. The Blight marches on. And soon, there'll be no escaping sights like these. So our mission remains unchanged. We cannot stop until every Mother Crystal is gone, and their thirst for ether with them. The only one that remains in Storm is Drake's Tale in the Crystalline Dominion.
Our next target.
We're going to Twinside.
Frick.
It's the capital of the Empire these days. I wouldn't like to think how tightly guarded they've got the place. Not that that'll stop you, but we do well to scout it out before you go charging in.
We would indeed.
If you're off to the Dominion, you can take this great lump with you.
Goots.
Oh, I am sorry. Have you forgotten you're the most wanted man in the Twins? I thought you might like to disguise yourselves as the attendants of a travelling trader, assuming you've no better ideas. You wanted to buy yourself some tools, didn't you? Well, now's your chance.
You're letting me go with them? Oh, thanks, Nan!
Stop that! You'll break me bones, you great galoot! There's a caravan that runs back and forth between the Dominion and the Boklav markets. It's managed by the Merchants Guild. Just show them Goots' trader's pass and you'll be on your way. It'll be a damn sight less risky than footing it the length of the Crystal Road. That's for sure.
Thank you, Karen. And glad to have you with us, Goots.
Okay then. I'll get me things and I'll meet yous there. See yous down in Boklad!
Get off! Me poor fingers!
Jill, you're with me.
Understood.
And Gav?
Already on my way, Captain.
Be careful.
Aren't I always?
I'm nervous for Gav, but I feel like they're not gonna kill him, right? I don't know. I mean, they really could. They've killed much better people.
You see that, Sid? Your protege's making a proper little outlaw of himself.
All right, where are we going? We're headed there. New area for the first time in a long time, I feel like. I mean, I guess not a long time. We did the Dalmachia stuff recently. But we're on the way to the Empire. I'm just waiting for the next time that the game warns me, like, oh, if you continue with this quest, the game is going to dramatically change, or the world will dramatically change. Those messages scare the fuck out of me. All right, here we are. Onward. We've been on that other quest. I already forgot what it was called. Out of the Shadow.
Better.
We've been on that for a while.
Thanks to Taya.
Oh my god, there's a side quest here.
I'm glad to hear it.
And Torgal helped too. Didn't you, boy?
Seems to be the only quest available. Oh, I guess I could be riding my chocobo, but
this used to be a trade road for merchants crossing the Scars. Till the Republic laid a new road wide enough to let wagons pass. And all official traffic moved there.
leaving this one for those living outside the law.
Indeed. I doubt we'll be the only outlaws on the trail today.
Run like the wind!
Alright, so we can go down there. I'm assuming it's like gonna loop around and then start descending or something.
You deserve a rest.
All right, so what do you boys want? Jonas? We'd be lucky it's really? The fifth Jonas brother.
As bad as that?
Oh, why? There's trouble up ahead.
I take it that...
Hopefully it's just like on the way. That'd be honestly perfect.
This fearsome looking fellow.
Oh, no doubt. Well met, friend. My brother and...
How does it merge?
Oh, the man's a coward. When he thought goblins might come a-snarling, he ran.
He sent the two of us to fetch it, but it's gone.
My brother's right on all accounts.
We may have seen our share of action.
You, however, chances are they'll come for you either way.
Well, if I'm going to have to deal
with prediction,
anyway,
these two are the bandits.
A fine head.
We're lucky you now. Hoping to make a heavy purse in Boklad. Reckon he won't be forking over the rest of our fee if we don't find those...
All right.
Nope, nope. You just put an end to those bandits and point...
I'm not sure I trust those two.
That's what I'm saying.
But if there are bandits lying in wait, I should probably take it.
Look lively, you lot! We've got guests!
These must be our bandits.
Oh, either I only need to kill this one, or we coincidentally killed all the enemies at the same time. But I definitely didn't touch those new enemies that were approaching.
That's them dealt with. Now, where's that cart?
Surprised there's not a chest or something in here.
Out of here will be a nightmare.
Seems we found ourselves the right man for the job, wouldn't you say?
Are they about to betray me?
Found the cart and didn't leave a single bastard breathing. Our merchant friend will be delighted.
And how exactly will he be getting his goods out of here?
You leave that to us. After all, it'd be wrong to make such a fine warrior haul cabbages to market.
You've done your part. And that's all you need to worry about. Here. It's been a pleasure. Now piss off.
Damn.
There's no need to be so rude, brother. What if we want his help again next time?
I don't get that quest, so I'm sure there's going to be a second part of it. Or it's just a weird-ass quest, but... the gamer in me is telling me that that's not the last time I'm going to see them.
I see the Dalmex lag behind Rosaria when it comes to bridge building.
The fallen ruin should hold, at least. The path continues on the other side.
Are these enemies? Yep. Damn. That looks cool as fuck. The final sin.
So this is Amekis.
The land of the gods. It's even more impressive than I imagined. I remember being captivated by the story as a child.
Long, long ago, man was overcome by avarice. Challenged the gods in a bid to win their power. A final battle took place here.
Yeah, Niagara Falls.
These falls.
If I ever go to Niagara Falls, I'm so pissing off the side of it.
If anyone ever manages to plumb those depths, perhaps we'll learn if there's any truth to the tale.
That the gods emerged victorious and punished man for his defiance by visiting upon him two curses.
Oh my god, there was also a holy shit. I'll say it after this cutscene.
Bearers.
Crazy.
To tell the truth, I always thought it strange that the dominant and their icons were deemed a curse. Back home, the dominant inherited the throne. They were admired and exalted, not spurned. Whenever I got to that part of the story, I always assumed there must be something I'd misunderstood.
You had a lot of storybooks, didn't you? In your room, I mean. When we were young.
The old legends were always my favorites. Epic battles between gods and men. Father encouraged me to read as much as I could. He thought it good for my education.
You really were a boy like any other, weren't you?
Just look at this place. It's enough to make you believe the legends are true.
I know.
We're not far from Boklad. The road will be busier up ahead.
And we'll have to keep our wits about us. Something wrong?
Nothing. It's nothing.
If Josh was nearby and he just like felt him in the air and we keep missing each other, I'm gonna be fucking pissed.
See, the reports are true, Father. You have surrendered the throne to
Olivier. Oh yeah, this did happen.
I have. Emperor Olivier shall rebuild the Holy Empire.
Dude, this is like some Joffrey Game of Thrones bullshit. Doesn't make no sense. Like, what the fuck is this little kid gonna do as king?
How is he to rule an
empire? That's what I'm saying.
He is but a boy.
I shall advise him until he comes of age.
So why wouldn't you just be the king?
Or for as long as I
It doesn't make sense.
The empire we seek to build needs young blood to rule it. And I can think of none better suited to the task. There is other news, Dion. Hugo Kupka is dead, and Drake's Fang destroyed. The pillars of the Republic have fallen. Ere long, the Imperial banner shall fly over every city in storm. And then, Valis Thea. All shall bow before their Emperor.
Father, these are the words of a tyrant.
They are the words of a god.
And you're not one, so why the fuck are you saying it?
Gladly serve. Great Grieger, made flesh.
Just turn into Bahamut and eat him. He's not the Emperor. Why do you need to bow to him?
Return to your camp, Dion, and ready your forces. It is time to show the world the true power of Sanbreak.
Father, I find you much changed. Is this truly the path you wish to tread? Or are these the ambitions of another? Of Ultima, perhaps?
What nonsense is this? I speak my mind, and my mind only.
This seems stressing me out.
Though I do owe Annabella thanks for reminding me of certain truths. Regarding the nature of nations, of rulers, and of the divine.
You trust the words of this traitress? She betrayed her country. She slew her husband.
Yes, she did.
You have ever been an invaluable servant to Sanbreak, Prince Dion. I trust you will continue to serve your emperor in the wars to come.
The canker!
Silence! Insolent wretch!
Like, I don't get this.
You will bend the knee. All else is heresy.
Sire, forgive me.
This audience is over. Come, your radiance. The Rowena Syndicate awaits your pleasure.
Oh, not another meeting with silly old men. They're so boring. I'm hungry, Father. Can't we have luncheon instead?
I hate that little fuck. I hope he gets just fucking, like, decapitated or something. I don't give a fuck if, like,
does it
oh...
pain you that you will not inherit
he's innocent, and it's
throne?
All just, like, the queen who's manipulating him. I don't give a fuck.
I have suffered worse.
Count your blessings, Dion. For a base-born child to be chosen by Bahamut is miracle enough. You have risen high on his wings, but you shall rise no higher, lest your impure blood stain the throne.
Just like fucking stab her, dude. What do you know of his blood? Turn into Bahamut and eat her. How many times do I have to say it? It would be probably bad meal because she's a little bitch. But it would be a meal nonetheless.
The Boklab markets are to the north. We just need to hug the coast.
God damn. Anyway, what I was gonna say is, Blue, do you know, like, so I've been hinting that something cool is gonna happen in One Piece for a while, and it's been trending like every day on Twitter for like a month straight.
Infiltrating the,
do you know what's gonna happen? Because I was gonna say something about it, but I don't want to say something if you don't know what's gonna happen.
Has lost one capital already. We can be sure Sylvester will do everything. His power to hold on to Twinside. His troops are well trained and increasing in battle hardened. But this is to end.
Oh shit, I parried. I mean, of course I did. That's what I meant to do. Oh, this is literally just, you might. Well, because a trailer came out for it, and I thought that might be the hype that you need to watch again. Because the episode is airing August 6th, and I was going to watch it on stream, but I didn't want to watch it if you don't know what's going to happen. All I know is this will be the greatest episode of One Piece ever. It involves Luffy Magoofy. That's the spoiler. He just changes his name to Luffy Magoofy. And every time he hits someone, he goes, "Guyuk!"
They've closed. It's the road to Randalar.
If the siege breaks, they'll need more than this to stop the Imperial Legions marching on the capital.
Okay, we need to check out, we need to go up, check out this, and then head on up. About Jinbe? Okay, then I won't say anything. TLDR though, the single greatest episode of One Piece is about to happen. And you probably obviously won't catch up for it because it's happening in like, what the fuck, Ancient Sword? Because it's happening in like a week or two. But you should watch it.
This might take a while.
Blue, if you catch up for it, I don't know what I would do, but that would be one of the most impressive things you could do. You need to get from episode, whatever episode you're on, which I think is like in the 700s, to 1071, I think. Okay, this is definitely gonna be where you fight a hunt, for sure. All I will say is what happened. So I saw spoilers for the manga when this thing first happened. What is about to happen made me start reading the manga. Because I was like, I can't wait for the anime to do this. This weekend? Hell yeah. Once you get to Wano and the animation changes, it'll be easy. Whole Cake Island. I don't like the arc that much, but people like the arc, so you might like it. I like parts of the arc, I just don't like the villain. I imagine, though, like, when it comes out, just be careful of social media. Because, like I said, for me, it's been trending already for, like, a month straight. Like, for the For You trending page, not, like, the actual trending page.
This is where we're supposed to meet Goots, isn't it?
But when it comes out, it might be trending. Here after replenishing. Like, it has been blowing the fuck up, just the hype for it.
I dare say he'll have finished by now. What do you think, girl?
Damn, I like, didn't even see this.
Hurry, man. I must leave for the Dominion post haste.
Bloody cruising caravans scooping up all this.
Yo, an orchestrion roll. Yeah, I mean, definitely, like, the best thing, in my opinion, so far. And, I mean, obviously, if I say best thing in the show, that's just kind of dumb, because, like, when Bro becomes King of the Pirates, I mean, like, goddamn, that shit's gonna be crazy.
Out of my sight, wretch.
What are you looking
for?
And
this probably won't compare to that.
Hey, Gilbert.
Yeah, that smile. Shit was fucking cool as shit.
Peaches and pears.
Wonders from across the water. Come one, come all. Feast your eyes. Good sir, can I interest you in...
How much? For a measly crust of bread?
You won't find any cheaper. Not nowadays. But you're more than welcome to look.
The Empire's unlawful and illegitimate occupation of the crystalline dominion is still in effect. Only those whose business in Twinside has been officially...
Yeah, I mean, like, even just look at this, which isn't too spoilery. It's just, like, a recent fight. But, like, even this, which was last week, is fucking crazy. Like, this video, I would say, looks literally nothing like what you're watching right now. Like, it almost looks like a different show. His fucking aura just turned into a dragon. And it pretty much just, like, once you get to Wano is when, like, the big shit changes. Which you're, like, an arc or so away.
Approved by the Republican Army will be permitted to cross the border. All who seek entry at a formal line and ready their documents for inspection.
Looks like we aren't the only ones who are eager to leave.
And they're checking everyone.
Can't you make an
exception? Not for the likes of you.
We won't get through without that pass. Let's go in and find Good, shall we? He must be around here somewhere.
Come taste my peaches!
Yeah, exactly. Then you just watch once a week. And it's a GG.
Good. There you are.
Clive, I'm so sorry. Don't tell Nan, will you?
Slow down, Good. Just tell us what happened.
And what's happening right now in the manga? Crazy. I really think, like,
it's gone.
We are gearing up to the end of One Piece, which is, like, insane to think about.
Do you remember when you last saw it?
It was in my pocket a minute ago. Then a bairn bumped into me and... you don't think that they might have nicked it, do you?
It wouldn't surprise me. A busy market like this is prime territory for pickpockets.
So, to get the pass back, we need to find this child. Where would we even start?
I know where! I've got a pal in Boklad who might be able to help us. No one knows more about what goes on round here than she does.
Where do we find her?
She's the owner of the Crimson Caravans, up that way. Sign's got a red chocobo on it.
No time like the present.
You two go on ahead. I'm gonna check the rest of me stuff, make sure...
All right.
Cool.
Let's keep an eye for this red chocobo, then.
And the other on our purses.
Next to the checkpoint.
It might end soon. Maybe once I talk to... who's ever at the Crimson Caravans. Oh, here's the red chocobo.
Looking to hire a coach?
Sure.
It's 10 million for a two-birder to the Crystalline Dominion. Take it or leave it.
Oh, we're not here for that.
Then I bid you good day.
Wait! Don't go, El. He's my mate.
As I live and breathe. Goots. What are you doing back in Boklad? I gather Lady Karen didn't send you. So what trouble have you got yourself into this time?
It's me trader's pass. It got stolen. By little Bern.
Of all the... You're the size of a marble. Honestly. Ugh. Goots told us that you know the markets well. Might you have an idea which little Bern could have done this?
We don't intend to punish them. We just need our pass back. Then, we can be on our way.
I see. So neither of you has a trader's pass either. Not that anyone would take you for traders, but I suppose that's why you came to me, correct? Now, I can't say for sure who took your pass, but I suspect I know why they did it. Let me explain.
We don't need an explanation. They probably just want it to, like, get across the way, I'd imagine.
Ever since the Fist marched on the Dominion, the Republic has been clamping down on any commerce that might aid the Empire, which means traders' passes have gone from being merely
exactly.
A way of easing one's
and with I demand said that.
Outstripping supply, they've become a precious commodity, leading some to seek to acquire them by less than legitimate means.
Hell yeah.
So the children are stealing passes to sell on the black market. Josh? Yes and no. Passes are inscribed with the names of their owners. And yet, none of the victims' names have appeared on the register of those passing through the checkpoint.
Which means?
That someone is doctoring the stolen passes. The same someone who is encouraging the children to steal them. And the same someone who has Goots's pass, no doubt. Whoever they are, they're ruining the livelihoods of honest merchants. Which is why we've decided to take a stand. Will you stand with us? You want to get your pass back. And we want to ensure that no more are stolen. Catch whoever's behind it all, and two birds shall be slain with a single stone.
Is there any other way of getting to the Crystalline Dominion, Goots?
They won't let you in if you're not with the caravan. It's that, I don't know, try swimming across the strait, but... Well, the guards will definitely spot you if you try and do that, like, and we don't want to get spotted, right?
So either we find the people who took the pass, or give up all hope of entering the Dominion.
All right. We'll help.
Thank you. But I don't know your name. Eloise at your service.
Clive.
A pleasure doing business.
Deal obtained. Cool.
The proprietor of the furniture makers by the coach stop, I suggest...
The furniture.
Yeah, it seems like a lot. I mean, even like a long, long time ago, I was looking at like Pokemon ROM hacks, and that's a fucking easy-ass like 2D game where you don't have to do much, and I can only imagine what 64 ROM hack is like.
Out of my sight, wretch.
Come on!
Jug of snake spit for the road.
The caravan stops next to the check.
Show them your trader's part.
Are you the furniture maker?
Looking for something in particular? Ah, and Eloise collared you too, eh?
She told me you were leading the hunt for the pickpockets.
For one, that they're targeting the traders carrying the biggest pack. Harder to watch your back, see? And less chance of the mark giving chase if they're spotted. Not that they'd be likely to catch them. Those imps know every inch of this warren like the backs of their hands.
Their eyes must have lit up when they saw Goots.
The fishmonger round by the gate's been trying to track down the children involved. You should go and have a word with her.
Thank you.
Thank you, we will.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
You should come with me to the Dominion.
Fish for sale! Fresh, sorted, and smoked! Can I interest you?
Ah, sorry. Message from Eloise, is it?
She's asked me to help her. To help you find the pickpockets.
Is that so? Suppose I better tell you what I know, then. For one, this isn't a family operation. All the traders say the children who stole their passes were dirty, dressed in rags. Street urchins, by the sound of it. We get a lot around here.
Orphans from the wars.
A few, perhaps. You saw the refugees gathered by the entranceway? They're all looking for a new start in the Dominion and beyond. Some of them take it as an opportunity to rid themselves of unwanted baggage.
The shame of it.
Whoever's behind this would have to have made themselves known to the children at some point.
And so should we.
You should start with the children around here, then. I doubt they're the ones...
It's worth it.
All right, then.
All right, this quest seems very fetch questy.
What can that be?
Come taste my peaches!
Well, we just need to, go talk to like 17 different people.
I was just wondering if anyone has asked you to do anything out of the ordinary recently.
Anything you grown-ups ever ask us to do is shut up and go away.
Damn.
So guess what I'm about to tell you to do?
Sorry. I'll leave you alone.
What the frick? I will literally curb stomp this little bitch. If he speaks back to me one more time.
You won't find anything of this quality in Twinside.
You look suspicious.
Do you
have mainly you just look like someone out of Assassin's Creed.
What I want is to know who's asking children like you to pick pockets.
I don't know. Nobody's asked me. What's picking pockets? Do you get paid for it?
No, you get in trouble for it.
No, you die.
If they come calling, you know what to tell them.
And stops next to the checkpoint.
Jug of snake spit for the...
Excuse me.
What do you want? I don't have any money.
It's all right. We're not going to hurt you. We just want to talk.
What?
We've heard that some very bad people are making children like you steal from travelers. We need to know who's behind it so we can stop them.
I don't know much about it, really. But my friend, Honza, he said he got a job. Doing something dangerous.
Sounds promising.
We need to.
Do you know where
he's usually by the?
Thank you.
By the tents outside town. I'm just trying to speed run this fetch quest.
That's that then.
She must have been the refugee camp.
Let's hope he's still nearby.
There are no crystals here. We have to...
That big fat donkey was easy pickings. He wouldn't have noticed if we'd robbed his boots off him.
Yeah. Wish we hadn't handed over the pass, though. Could use one of those things to get out of this dump.
Chance would be a fine thing. The moment they found out, they'd string us up by our guts.
Would they now? Perhaps you'd like to introduce us to these... charming character.
Shit! We're in trouble now!
What do we
do? You two get...
Honza! Where are you going?
Okay, well, you know that's
so
the
that
one.
That was Honza, right? Jill, you watch the...
All right.
He can't have gone far. I need to find him before his employers do.
All right. Honza. Oh, is it... Oh. I thought that he was just right here.
Did you see a boy run past?
There was a boy ran back there.
Thank you.
Dude, he's literally just standing there.
Oh, shit. Cornered.
It's all right, Honza. I'm not going to hurt you. I just want to ask you some questions.
Fine.
I'm looking for the people who are making you steal for them. Who are they?
Call themselves the Carstones. They said they'd give me a good gill if I did what they told me. I knew they were bad, but bread doesn't come for free. didn't come at all half the time before I started buzzing for them. You know, if I didn't do it, they just pick up.
Yeah, frick C. I never liked C.
Honza.
You found him then?
Jill. Where are the other two?
Eloise is watching over them. She sent Gutz and I to look for you.
You're... him!
I haven't got your pass anymore, if that's what you're after. I gave it to the Carstones. Whatever you do to me, I can't... Not that I go against them anyway. If it weren't for their guilt, me and my mates would have starved.
Cowards! You will not force another child to do your bidding.
This dude thinks that I'm the people who thinks that he's the people, that I'm the people, that you're the people, man.
Don't hurt him.
You're making a mistake.
We're on the same side. Like hell we are. That brooch. Where did you get it?
Theo. Didn't he see Gutz?
Gutz.
Yeah, okay.
What are you doing with these people? Unless you're the ones my sister was talking about.
Your sister?
Eloise, I imagine.
Eloise didn't tell us she had a brother.
And why would she? I'm just her back and a blade. Theodore, at your service. Sorry about before.
Theodore, what do you know of the Cast Stones?
Vultures who have made Boklad their hunting ground. They prey on the desperate, stealing from those with Gil and bullying those without it into joining their flock. I'd been looking into their activities in hope, but it seems they've already Hansa's a good lad. If he and his friends hadn't agreed to work for the Stones, some other poor souls would have. On pain of death, most likely. Clive was, and my sister's asked you to help, but then we all won.
Cool. To catch a thief. To catch a predator.
Oh.
So... what's the plan?
What else? You get your traders pass back and...
all right, then.
All right. Honza, where are they camped? Don't worry. They'll never know you told us.
Couldn't if I wanted to. They always come to town to collect the passes. Meet us outside the gate. I tried following them once, but they spotted me halfway down the trail. Said they'd string me up.
We'll try it this time.
Back down the road towards Leighton's Cleft.
Isn't that the beginning of this area? What the hell? Oh, another... damn. This one quest is split in, like, three different ones. I said I was gonna end, but I think I'll keep playing for a little while longer. I wanna get into the Crystalline Dominion. Assuming this is the only thing we have to do to get into there. But if she's like, oh, and then we gotta do this for me, and then you gotta do this for me, blah, 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 then maybe not.
Track.
Go through this again. It's probably gonna happen like 3 times, and then we actually find them.
Some of our new recruits are natural-born ne'er-do-wells.
Especially the little one.
Scum.
The leaders.
They don't deserve it.
I wasn't planning on...
We're ready when you...
Oh, I'm...
I love that Clive is just out here killing people. And not doing any of this, like... But if we stoop down to their level, then we're not any better. It's like, frick up, dude. That was pretty easy.
And they say crime doesn't pay. Gold chains, rings, purses. Ah, and traders' passes. Dozens of them.
Have the names been changed?
Not yet. I recognize some of them. No doubt Gootz's is somewhere among them. Now I just need to sort through it all and return everything to the people it was taken from.
We should go and give Eloise the good news. Can we leave things here in your hands, Theodore?
Of course. Oh, and,
we'll be glad.
Yeah, I'll tell her. I'll tell her you were a freaking savage, man.
Clive, how goes the hunt? My brother isn't getting in your way, I trust?
Quite the op.
Quite the oppie.
So it was the cast stones who were behind it all. Theo told me he'd been on their trail. And their demise solves three problems at a stroke. That of the pickpockets, the bandits pulling their strings, and the passes they were stealing. I only hope yours is among the items you recover. Speaking of whom...
You are too kind, Eloise. Here, Clive. Goods is part.
I will. Thank you.
Thank you.
El, I've asked our boys to carry the rest of the goods back. Can I count on your help in sorting through it all?
Of course. I expect you'll soon be on your way then. But it wouldn't do... Would it now? Cid. Don't look so shocked. We're on the same side.
I don't understand.
As you now know all too well, we at the Crimson Caravans are always happy to help those in need. For a small fee, we will move anything that needs moving, be that goods to market or bearers away from it.
I was the first my sister helped escape. If it wasn't for her, I'd have been branded as a boy.
I had no idea.
It just so happens that we are seeking to expand our operation. And who better to join forces with than the leader in the field? Wouldn't you agree, Theo?
I would. It seems our purpose is the same in more ways than one. So what would you say to working together again?
Oh god, this is gonna open up a side quest.
And our honor. The honor.
Here, Clive.
What is it?
El has friends in high places, while I have associates in, lower ones.
Deal joined. Oh wow, the collar and compass. That's cool.
I shall bear it.
Well, all that remains is to wish you a safe onward journey. Gutz's pass should secure you a place on the caravan. But if you encounter any difficulties, we would be delighted to provide you with a coach of our own. For a discounted price, of course. Say... 9 million?
We'll... try the caravan.
You got me fucked up if you think I'm paying 9 million. Thunderstorm? Hi, Ben.
Right then. Let's get this back to Gutz.
Oh, 3 side quests? No, sir. I said I was gonna end soon, and I think I'm gonna end now. God damn. That's too much for right now. I will do them. And I could just skip them for now, but what if I'm on a quest soon that's like, hey, if you complete this quest, the world is gonna change. So I don't wanna do... What the fuck? What happened? I've never touched one of these.
This isn't the first time I've seen one of these. Perhaps I can use them as waymarks.
What the fuck? Wow, you're gonna become a movie guy. Okay, but yeah, I think I'm gonna end for now. Like I said, maybe stream tomorrow, maybe not. I'm going to Oppenheimer at 6, and that movie's 3 hours. Or 6:30, you know, it's 3 hours. I could stream before it, but there's a stream I want to watch that starts at like 12. I don't really know how long that's gonna go. So, it mainly just depends on that. Probably wouldn't stream when I got home, but I mean, I guess it's a possibility. It's a weekend. I could start at 9:30. Okay. That's going to do it for today. I'll talk to you outside about that, Ben. And, yeah.
Later, gamers.